Hello and welcome back to Music Mitra. My name is Bindu Nair. If you are new to this channel, let me request you to please subscribe and click the bell icon so that you can see the new videos on this topic and also show your support for this channel. So far we have discussed major topics about Indian classical music or Carnatic music to be precise. Today's topic is Kalpana Sangeeta versus Kalpita Sangeeta. I'm sure you've heard of these two terms being used in the context of Indian classical music. So let me first start with explaining the two major aspects of Indian classical music. Whether it is in Carnatic or in the Hindustani system, there are two aspects to learning and understanding music. The first aspect is what is already there out for you to see in the form of documented compositions, the notes, the ragas, their grammar, etc. All that is what already there, which can be referred to, which can be read or sung, etc. That part is known as Kalpita Sangeeta. Then that's only 50%. When you go to a concert, what you hear is 50% Kalpita Sangeeta, and sometimes even more than 50% what you hear is Kalpana Sangeeta. What is Kalpana Sangeeta? Naturally, it is the other part of the music that which doesn't form part of Kalpita Sangeeta is Kalpana Sangeeta. Kalpana itself, the word itself, mentions Kalpana, meaning imagination. So the aspect of music where the musician's imagination comes into play is known as Kalpana Sangeeta. So Kalpita Sangeeta is something where there's nothing for imagination. It's already out there. You just reproduce what is already there. That part is known as Kalpita Sangeeta. And what is left to the imagination of the artist is known as Kalpana Sangeeta. I hope this explains these two concepts. Now I'll give you examples so you know exactly what we are talking about. In Kalpita, we can say things like the lessons that we learn in music, the compositional forms we learn. So the lessons include your basic lessons, Sarali Varses, Jante Varses, Alankaras, Geetams, Swarajatis, Jatiswarams, all that comes under Kalpita Sangeeta. It's already there. The teacher will just teach you and you learn it as it is there already. Varnams, Kritis, all that is Kalpita Sangeeta. What about Kalpana? Kalpana Sangeeta is what is left to the imagination. So like Alapana, Neraval, Swaraprastara, all that which the artist improvises on with the foundation of the Kalpita Sangeeta, you create the Kalpana Sangeeta. So that is also known as Manodharma Sangeeta. So what you see, the improvisations on stage, that is Manodharma Sangeeta or Kalpana Sangeeta. So I hope you understood these two concepts today. See you soon in another video. Bye until then.